Yeah, good evening. Today I would like to share with you some of the challenges which are faced by the mining engineers during the project evaluation process, just to establish the viability of the mining project. As you can see here, I've got an arbitrary pit design which I've just indicated there. This is obviously established after, you know, all the drilling has been done and some statistical, you know, analysis, geostatistical analysis has been done, you know, special variability of grade and everything has been done. So we've come up with our geological model, okay, which is now superimposed onto our pit design after some other geotechnical, you know, analysis which has been done just to establish, you know, the actual slope angles for our pit. Okay, forget about this part of the ore which I've indicated. Basically, this zone, it indicates the part which is highly oxidized, and some of it has got some refractory ore, which is obviously very, very difficult to process. So I'm not going to talk about anything that starts from this bench going upwards. Obviously, we'll just treat it as well. So maybe just as a forward, I would like to discuss a bit about waste. You know, waste is basically a non-mineral bearing material, and it's normally found, you know, either lying on top of the ore body, you know, or maybe side by side, you know, and should be mined to expose the ore for safe extraction. Okay, so mining unnecessary ore, obviously, as we are aware, that is a liability to the company, and hence there is a need to come up with a tactical approach, you know, to be able to extract this ore in a safe and environmentally friendly manner. But remember, the things which we are discussing at this stage, these things, they are only, we are doing it a long-term stage, whereby the long-term mining engineer has to come up with a bangable feasibility report, you know, that indicates exactly how and we are going to be handling money and how much money we are going to spend during the extraction process, and how much metal content we're going to recover, you know, during each and every financial year. Okay, so now the bottom line is we are now faced with the challenge to establish the mining sequencing methods, the best methods to extract this ore body, you know, in tandem with the waste that is supposed to be mined. It's each and every particular period. So I think we are all aware that we've got the four types of mining sequencing methods, which is basically the maximum stripping ratio methods, the minimum stripping ratio methods, also referred to as the increasing stripping ratio, and also the constant stripping ratio method, and the phased mining method. So I will discuss, to start with, the maximum stripping ratio. This axis is showing the stripping ratio, you know, with time. So, okay, the maximum stripping ratio is telling us that, you know, during the initial stages of the life of mine, we have to handle as much waste as possible, and only extract as very little ore as possible. And as you can see, maybe just explain on this diagram, you can see that we will be able to get all this waste just to get this minimal ore which we're going to get in this portion. But as we also know that mostly the upper part of the ore body, because of the oxidation process which happened there, it is likely that this material is also low grade. So we're going to get all this bulky waste just to be getting this low grade. Obviously, the metal content that we're going to recover is very, very little. And so meaning during the entire, assuming this is maybe something like 10 million tons of waste, which we can maybe extract within the first 1 or 2 years, that means the project is not going to be generating any funding, you know, for the first 1 or 2 years. The funding that is required to meet all the capital expenditure requirements for the monies that we invested in the business before we started the project. So it is an assumption that if we are going to mine all this and extract only this little ore, which is obviously low grade, and the metal content we're going to recover is very little, then what it means is, okay, this method, the maximum stripping ratio method, is not going to help us in any way, because obviously we are not going to make any money within the first 1 or 2 years. So the company is not going to be generating any much revenue, even though there will be some revenue, but there wouldn't be any revenue that is something that we can mention. So it is detrimental to the NPV. Yeah, it is detrimental to the NPV. So now looking at the minimum stripping ratio or the increasing stripping ratio, basically what we are saying is, on this one, we are saying for us to be able to mine this block, okay, obviously we just need to strip only very little waste which is lying on top of the block, because obviously here there's no ore, there's no waste that we're going to handle there. We're going to just handle just waste within this vicinity, okay, so that we are able to extract this whole block safely. And the process, it continues repeating itself, just like that. But at some stage, using this same method, we might not be able to get to even part of this block, because there's material which is covering this block. And we obviously need to develop a ramp all the way. So meaning we'll have to go back and start stripping the waste that we left by the time we've been mining here. So meaning during the time we're going to be mining here, there'll be quite a lot of waste that we're going to be handling during that particular time. That is why you find the stripping ratio is increasing with time, because we dived into the ore and, you know, of course enjoy it during the initial stages of the business, but at some stage, as the time moves, okay, let's say year 3, year 4, year 5, thereabout, we are going to be experiencing a lot of, you know, cost on waste stripping. Remember, the cost of ore mining and the cost of waste stripping is basically the same when we are moving the ore from the pit to the stockpiles and from the pit to the overburden stockpile. So this minimum stripping ratio is very difficult to schedule, okay, due to the, you know, number of blocks. Somehow you need to take another number of blocks, you know, you need to get some of the ore, and you also need to get to waste, you need to get, you know, it is quite very difficult to schedule, and it is, you know, ultimately detrimental to our NPV. What is happening is, as we start handling a lot of waste as time progresses, it means the company might not be making any profit during that period, you know, considering the fact that we have already chewed some of the money during the initial stages of the project, and this side maybe we're just getting some marginal profits, you know, otherwise it's not something that is viable to the business. Now I'll talk about the constant stripping ratio. In this stripping ratio, what happens is that during the entire life of mine, we the ratio between the waste and the ore that we are going to move at any particular time is going to be constant, and the labor and equipment requirements from the start of the project to the end is also very, 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 very constant. And it is also, so meaning the amount of waste that we are going to be handling from the start of the project all the way up to the entire life of mine is constant. So that means we are more like in a tight or binding constraint, whereby any challenge to our business, we are going to start diving and start making a loss. So this is very, very detrimental to our NPV. So I wouldn't suggest that we use this constant. Maybe it may work in some other situations, but you know, in this regard, it is not going to work. Then the last And the best sequencing method is the first mining method, whereby during the initial stages of the business, you come here and, you know, develop, you know, it's, you know, just enough for you to be able to get the ore that you need to get. Obviously, the ore that you're going to get, you process it, you get your monies so that you can be able to pay for your initial capital investments, you know, that you make in the business. But we just need to focus on paying for the equipment, paying for the buildings, paying for the plant that we've already constructed, and also paying for the initial developments that we've done to the business. So what we are saying is, you know, we just need to maintain the stripping ratio as low as possible. Then at some stage, let's say after year five or so within this vicinity, what we are saying is, because, okay, the equipment is now belonging to us and we've already developed the pit, we can afford, okay, to, because obviously what we're saying is, remember, whenever we are paying for equipment, we pay it on higher purchase. And let's say by year five, we're no longer spending all those monies on equipment payments. So meaning we can now, the money that we've been using on paying for all those higher purchases, we can now take that money and allocate it to waste stripping, massive waste stripping, so that, you know, as time progresses, we're also going to lower the stripping ratio to a certain level. Once we've developed that area to a certain point, and then as time now, we are now moving towards the end of the life of mine, then we intend maybe to make sure that, okay, the stripping ratio may go down, because remember, this is when now we are also looking at reclamation or rehabilitation costs that we're spending. So the money that we've been spending on waste stripping and etc., we now, you know, rechannel the monies to reclamation or rehabilitation activities, like maybe, you know, restoration of the land, etc., something like that. So basically, that's why I said, let me just share with you some of the challenges which are faced by the mining engineers. So basically, this is part of the evaluation process, and the results of whatever we are going to be doing from this site, the evaluation process, are going to be inputted into the financial evaluation model that we use for establishing the viability of the mine, so as to find out how much money we're going to be indicating the cash flows that we're going to be getting by the end of the month, I mean the year. We're looking at the NPVs, you know, and then you spread it over the entire life of mine. Thank you very much.